Let me start. Okay. In the previous session, we have completed the microwave network theory part. We have seen how the S parameters are represented, what are its advantages, what are the relationship between the different parameters, S parameters, and we have even seen what are the properties of S matrix. Okay, and we have even proved some 2 to 3 properties as well. So, in connection with those, okay, we have seen in the module 2 first part, that is S parameters, S matrix. The second half, it deals with some of the microwave passive devices and for some devices like waveguides, how to write or how to find the S parameters or S matrix. So it's a link, it's a linked topic. So having studied S matrix representation, S parameters concept, we will connect it with how to get the S parameters or S matrix for some of the microwave devices. Okay. Now, directly the heading is given microwave passive devices. But you know, in general, even in your electronics, you come across two different types of devices, active and passive devices, right? So you know what is the difference between an active device and a passive device. Please, can anybody tell me? Just like in case of electronics, you know about what is an active device and a passive device. Even we come across these categories in microwave communication as well. Okay, so the heading is passive devices, but let us see a brief introduction. Okay, so microwave devices and components, they are essential building blocks of microwave circuits and systems. Definitely, without these devices, how will you work with the microwave circuits and how will you establish the communication? You require these devices and components, okay? And you know already the microwave frequency range, it is from 300 megahertz to 300 gigahertz, and the wavelength specifically, it is 1 meter to 1 millimeter, okay? Microwave circuits, they are the combination of both active and passive components. Definitely, even in case of your electronic circuits also, it's a combination. Here we come across the microwave active and passive components. And important note here, without passive components, active components cannot be operated. You know, you have everything with you, but without the passive components, how will you connect? How will you establish the communication? It is a very essential part. So in the circuit, even if you have active components, without passive components, you cannot work. Remember. So microwave, now coming to passive devices in specific. Okay. So microwave passive components, they may be composed of, in general, any lumped elements or some distributed elements or some sections of transmission lines, you know, a part of the transmission line. They may contain this or discontinuities. Microwave passive devices and components, they are designed using a section of either coaxial line or a waveguide or a strip line. Strip lines and all, they are all the transmission lines, okay? Antennas, in antennas we use them for use in both laboratory purpose as well as in microwave communication systems. So they are designed using the sections of these lines. Remember, even you can imagine, agar aapka ek water connection hai, you use pipes, right? They are like your transmission lines. And even though you have that those lines, without connectors, you know, that your pipe is of no use. Without connectors, how will you connect it to your tap or your whatever water supply system? Without that, it's of no use. So this connector is one of the passive device, right? In analogy, I'm giving you an analogy. Even though you have a pipeline, you have a pipe with you, without the connectors using to connect, to establish the connection, you can't work out, okay? These components, they are considered as either one port or multi-port networks. They are characterized by the basic parameters like VSWR, that is a standing wave ratio, reflection coefficient, and different losses, that is insertion loss, transmission loss, reflection loss. We have already seen different losses in case of S parameters, right? So each of these passive components, they're having their own characteristics. Okay, unka ek specification hai that this is the reflection coefficient. If you use that in your system, okay, the value of the SWR is so and so, reflection coefficient will be so and so. So whenever you connect that particular component, you use that component in the microwave system. This is about generally, I have explained you about the passive components. Now coming to your specifically the first topic of your second module is, the second half of the second module is coaxial cable connectors and adapters. Okay, coaxial cable description is not there. You might be knowing how a coaxial cable looks like, right? Coaxial. So there will be a concentric cylinders connected inside and outside. The black color you might have seen in even in case of your televisions sets, cables, you can see this black round color cable, that is coaxial cable. So for your study, connectors are there. Okay, so let us study about these coaxial cables. They are terminated or connected to other cables or components. Obviously, how you establish a connection, you cannot have, even though you manufacture a long single coaxial cable throughout, you cannot use single cable throughout for laying, for establishing the connection, right? If the distance is in kilometers, how will you do it? You require some sections and you want those sections to be joined. So you require this connection establishment, right? For that, connectors are used. Again, in analogy, you can view a water pipe. Even though you may be having some long water pipe, plastic pipe, without connectors, you cannot use them. Okay. So coaxial cables are terminated or connected to other cables and components by means of shielded. Okay, there is a covering. Shielded stranded connectors. The outer shield makes a 360 degrees extremely low impedance joint. What do you mean by this 360 degrees? Can anybody tell me any connector you have come across? I think in your laboratories you use one common type of connector. Can anybody tell me which is that connector? Fine. Most commonly used connector which you might have come across in your day-to-day lives somewhere, okay, while probably in any of the appliances, is BNC connector. Okay, so to maintain, why you'll be having this impedance joint, 360 degree extremely low impedance joint. Okay, obviously when you connect it, in order to make a perfect connection, you have to rotate them, right? So the steel covering, what you get it just at the mouth of that connector, that will be 360 degrees, extremely low impedance joint. So to maintain a shielding integrity, okay, shielding integrity means there should not be any loss if you connect it. These connectors are of various types depending upon the frequency range and the cable diameter, right? So cable diameter kitna hoga specifically, and kaun se frequency range mein wo operate karega. These two are the parameters to decide the type of connector used. So commonly used microwave connectors are type N. It can be a male or female. Generally, this is the distinction connector. If they can be male or female, or even sometimes a sexless. Okay. So in the sense, it can be used on both ways. Okay, Boyenich, Neal, Conselman, that is BNC. Okay. BNC, even if it has either male or female, PNC, I have written the expansions of those below. Type N, N indicates navy. Okay. BNC is, as she said, it is Boyenich, Neal, Conselman, or many times BNC indicates bayonet navy connector. Okay, BNC. TNC is a threaded navy connector. Iska advanced version hi hai ye. SMA, sub miniature A. These are the names of different connectors, and APC, amphenol precision connector. So these are some of the types, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, some five categories are there, five different connectors are there. I'll show you the pictures also, how they look. And adapters, they're having different connectors at the two ends. They're also made at the two ends. You can use this adapters having different connectors at the two ends. Try to understand. For interconnection between the two different ports, even this is possible. Okay, that's why if you use an adapter, or for adapter, you're having a connector at two different ends that are made of the, you know, the adapters, they're having different connectors at their two ends in order to establish the connection between two different ports. Okay, that is also possible. Now coming to the different classification, let me start with APC. Shall I show you the figures first? You will get the idea. Then I can just briefly explain you what are each terms. Amphenol. Okay, I guess it is clear to you. Male and female, you can see the difference. I hope you know what is a thread. Right, ye jo grooves hai, under lines hai, they are called threads. Okay, in male, ye jo under ke portion mein rehta hai ye, okay, connection under se hoga. Okay, ye kya hoga? This is a female, wherein the cover, the threads are at the outer side. So these are the lines, what you can see, they are called threads. So this is the difference. So in all these different connectors, both male and female version is available. Only for one specific connector you have, which is I think SMA or something. I'll just show you. It is sexless. It can be worked. It can be used to connect both. Okay. So this figure, hope you understood how they look like. Okay, the threadings. This is the first, that is APC 3.5. 3.5 indicates the diameter. Okay, diameter in mm's. And you have even APC 7 also. Ye jo maine first dikhaya hai aapko, APC 3.5 hai. APC 7 is also there. Next, BNC. Burnett, Neel, Kunselman or Bennett Navy connector. How they look, you can see. What is the difference, male and a female, how they look like, you know. This is BNC. The third type of connector is PNC. I think this is even coaxial cable mein ye more frequently aapne dekha hoga hai. You might have seen this TNC. Kyunki ye generally telephone lines mein shayad use hote hain ye. Next one is SMA. They are much smaller, okay? That's why the name miniature. Smaller versions. Again, in SMA, you have SMA and SMC. There are two types. Just look at the figures, okay? I'll explain each one. Type N, which is Navy connector. Even this is very commonly used. You might have come across aapka probe, it may look something like this only. Ye jo structure hai, aisa hi rehta hai, which you use in your CROs and even on signal generators. So hope you understood how they look, the connectors look. Now coming to the theoretical part about the description of each connector. So just as a theory question, write a note or explain the different types of connectors. So about APC 3.5, as I have shown you already. And yes, I was telling, each connector is having either male or female configuration, except only one, which is sexless. Okay, it can be used in connection to any of the cable. That is APC 7. okay, APC 3.5 and remaining all, they are both having two configurations except APC 7. Now, about the APC 3.5, this connector, it can operate up to a frequency of 34 gigahertz at the max 300 gigahertz a microwave frequency range. So it can operate up to the frequency of 34 gigahertz, and it has a very low VSWR. So standing wave ratio is less. Okay. And most of these connectors, they're having their, the characteristic impedance 50 or 75 K range mein rehta hai. And for APC 3.5, it has a characteristic impedance of 50 ohm. And the male connector, it introduces higher order modes. Higher order modes, mode is nothing but the field configuration inside the transmission line. Okay, jabhi bhi aapka wave propagate hota hai inside the transmission line, when your input wave propagates, the field distribution inside that transmission line, it changes, it varies. Okay, so as and when it propagates, it may happen that the modes are formed. The different configurations, the different configurations of your field distribution, electric field and magnetic field distribution occur. That we call it modes. Okay, and as and when you proceed, higher order modes are formed. Jitna higher order mode rahega, utna aapka power less hoga. Okay, so higher order modes, this will introduce. That's why you cannot use this above 24 gigahertz. Uska at the max, actually it can work up to 34 gigahertz, but if you are using a male connector, it will introduce higher order modes while propagation, because which will make a power loss. Okay, because of which 24 gigahertz is the maximum. With above this, you should not use it. Coming to APC 7, shall I show you APC 3.5 one more time? Okay. I'm talking about this. Okay, both configurations are available, both male and female. Either you can connect from inside or from the outside. Now coming to APC 7, which is used in both configurations. Again, it has got a characteristic impedance of 50 ohms, and it has a low VSWR, just like APC 3.5. But the operation frequency, the operational frequency, it is 18 gigahertz. These connectors are advantageous because they have a low reflection coefficient. Jitna reflection coefficient value kam hai, it means what? Loss will be less. Reflections kam hai. Making this repeatable coaxial connections and are genderless, as I told you. It can be used in both configurations. And BNC, coming to the third type of the connector. These connectors are best suited for the frequencies below 4 gigahertz, the lowest, okay? As they lose the mechanical stability as they get closer to 10 gigahertz. So at the max, it can, 4 gigahertz se zyada nahi, within that only, because if it reaches around 10 gigahertz, it will lose its mechanical stability. So it is extensively used in almost all electronic measuring equipments. As I told you, in your laboratory, you might have seen this BNC connector. It has a characteristic impedance of, again, 50 ohms and 50 to 75. This is the range in general. It is connected to a flexible coaxial cable with the diameters up to 0.635 centimeter. Diameter of coaxial cable is this. So up to this, you can connect BNC. Coming to the next, that is a TNC. I hope the explanation is understandable by you. And even APC, I did not tell you the abbreviation. APC. APC is Amphenol Precision Connector. Okay. Then coming to BNC, as I told you, Bayonet Navy Connector. Coming to TNC, it is actually Threaded Navy Connector. Okay, TNC is a Threaded Navy Connector. So it is just the advanced developed version of BNC. Okay, so the TNC, these connectors, they are weatherproof, miniature units, and they are the improved versions of BNC. how they are improved means in the sense that the outer conductor has a threads. Threads जो हैं वो outer conductor पे रहते हैं to make firm contact with the mating surface whenever you are using it for connection, for connecting the joint as a joint. It should be perfect. The firm contact should be established. For that, these grooves, these threads are there on the outer conductor. What will happen if very firm contact happens? There will be no leakage, right? No loss. So to minimize the radiation leakage at higher frequencies. So TNC, you can see the structure also. There is APC, BNC. TNC. ये जो आउटर कंडक्टर है, आउटर कंडक्टर के लिए आपको थ्रेड्स मिलेंगे, okay? So this is your inner conductor, this is your outer conductor. You are having the threads over on which because of those threads, whenever you connect it, okay, to a transmission line, there will be a very firm contact and there is no radiation leakage. This is about the TNC. And they operate up to 12 gigahertz and commonly used in cellular phone and RF antenna connections. Most commonly used TNC. Now coming to SMA. SMA stands for, let me just show you the abbreviation. SMA, sub-miniature A. These connectors are used for thin, flexible or semi-rigid cables. If you compare all other connectors with this SMA, you can see the structure. SMA, they are very much thin in as compared to the other structures of the connectors. So these connectors are used for thin, flexible or semi-rigid cables. The higher frequency, it is limited to 24 gigahertz. Okay, just like your APC 3.5. Above which, it will introduce higher order modes. And again, it has a characteristic impedance of 50 ohms. It is most commonly used in radio astronomy. This is one of the applications where this SMA cable connector is used. Then coming to the SMC. Have I written the abbreviation? No. Again, it is as I told you, SMA and SMC. There are two types. SMA is a sub-miniature A. SMC is a sub-miniature C. So this connector, it has a small size compared to SMA. Having again the 50 ohm characteristic impedance, it can be used up to the frequency of 7 gigahertz. I have written here in the bracket OSM. And Selectro Corporation. O stands for OPEC Spectra Manufacturer. It is manufactured by this. And these are the manufacturer names. OSM and Selectro Corporation. And you know, ये जो भी हैं आप देख रहे हैं, most of them they were developed. They were developed for during this World War II. For microwave applications. Even radar was developed during that only. Now coming to the type N, this is the basic type. Actually, this is the first, you know, the prototype, the first developed connector is this type N. After this only, the remaining all connectors, actually I should have taken this first and all others next. It is a threaded, weatherproof, medium-size RF connector. It is used to join coaxial cables, okay? And it was one of the first connectors, as I told you, it was the first connector developed, capable of carrying the microwave frequency signals. And this was invented in 1940s, somewhere around World War II. Originally, it was designed to carry the signals at frequencies up to 1 gigahertz, when it was developed. The frequency range was very limited, 1 gigahertz in military applications. But however, today, its capacity has increased. The common type N connector, it handles the frequencies up to 11 gigahertz, 1 to 11, drastic change. Okay, these are some 7 connectors I have listed. What you have to do, you have to list them. What are their operational frequencies? What are their characteristics? Okay, and for some, you can mention few applications. Okay, so these are different types of connectors which we come across, coaxial connectors. And here, as a summary, I have written, I have listed the different connectors here and their configurations. Type N connector is available in both configurations, means threads can be inside or outside. All these. However, APC7 is sexless. It can be used in both configurations. Connection can be inner or outer. APC3.5 sexed. The dielectric in mating space, when you connect them, the dielectric used is air in most of the cases. And for these three, it is solid. BNC, TNC, and SMA, it is solid. And as I told you, the characteristic impedance for these, it is around 50 to 75 ohms. So for first three, it is 50 or 75. For the remaining three, it is 50 ohms. So this is the summary how I have just listed the characteristics. Okay. I hope you understood. It's just a theoretical concept. You should be able to explain each connector. If possible, if you're able to draw it, it's well and good. At least where the threads are, how it looks like. If you draw it even nearer to that, it is okay. Let me just show you one more time these figures. This is APC 3.5. This is BNC connector. This ye jo hai na, this will be rotating 360 degrees. You can see the threading. Coming to TNC, you have outer threads, inner threads. Again, SMA. There are two here, SMC and SMA. One is smaller in size for thin and one is medium. Then type N, the basic type of connector. Okay, these are the different types of connectors which we come across in microwave systems. Now coming to the next concept, that is attenuators. Okay, some 2 to 3 types are there in attenuators. So we will be dealing that in the next session.